Greetings. So I want to talk about heuristic evaluations and introduce my recently released template that makes this process so much easier and more organized and more powerful. So I'll get into that in the next video, but for this one, I want to just first of all talk about heuristic evaluations. What are they? Why are they important? What are the benefits, right? And then I want to introduce you to the template that I recently released and walk through that. So that's what I'm going to do this video. So what are heuristics and what is a heuristic evaluation? Well, Jakob Nielsen created these 10 heuristics, believe it or not, in 1994. That was before even the infancy of the World Wide Web. I mean, it was like right at the onset, really. And it's just crazy to me and mind-blowing that these heuristics are still just as relevant today as they were even then. And it's mind-blowing because so much has changed, right, in the way that we present information to our users and the way that interface patterns have come about. And yet, again, these are still very relevant. So why do we do this? Well, one of the main reasons is to uncover severity levels in our software, right? Like we could have a mild issue, could be cosmetic. It could actually be incredibly severe or catastrophic as well. So it's really a great way to identify challenges and inconsistencies that may be prevalent in our software that perhaps nobody else is noticing, right? And that's what one of the things that's important about this. So our users might notice, but we may never hear from them, right? They may never either A, have the ability to share their feedback with us, or B, not have the time, right? And honestly, it's our problem, right? Like Steve Jobs said, if the user has a problem, it's our problem. Those are the reasons that we do this. And I highly recommend it to, especially if you're, you know, starting out at a company and kind of coming in with fresh eyes, to do this on your primary software platform. It really does help start a lot of conversations and help get you off and going with solving some problems. The process of this, it's really great to do this with at least three to five people. It helps open up a lot more opportunities, and they may see things that you don't see and vice versa. It's kind of a fun process actually to get more visibility to what you're doing as a UXer. If your users can't use your software and do business with you, that's a big problem, right? And that could affect your job and others' jobs as well. One of the best ways I've found to do this is to identify your top 10 tasks inside of your application. That way you can just kind of have a starting point to go after. And of course, while you're doing that, you will almost certainly discover a lot of other issues that are tangential even to these tasks. So it's a really good exercise. So I highly recommend it again. You can learn more. There's some links in the template. I'll walk through that in a second here. So that being said, let me go ahead and show you how to find the template, right? So there's a few different ways to do that. One way is to go to my website, jasonogle.com. And currently inside of my intro area, there is a link to it. And so you can click that. I actually also just recently made a redirect that might make it easier. Just go to jasonogle.com/HE, which stands for heuristic evaluation. And that'll take you to it. You can also go to, and I'm super honored, the guy who created these, Jakob Nielsen, has linked my template in his resources section here. So you can actually go there as well. So this is the template. It's very accessible and portable. It's Google Sheets, and you just have to have a Gmail account to access it. There's an easy way to make a copy right here, and you can get this working on your own. The formulas that I'll show you in a second, they don't work until you actually make a copy of this, but it's super powerful once you do. So you land here, you get a quick explanation of, you know, what are heuristics, why, the process, And then there's the heuristics outcome. I forgot to mention this earlier, but obviously after you do this work, you want to find a way to communicate this out to other folks in the organization, right? Especially engineers and product managers and stakeholders. So what you want to do is you want to, you know, get these results. I'll show you how to do that in a second. This template is super powerful in that it actually calculates your findings for you, and it allows you to create, you know, like something like a results graphic. This is an example of one that I did on my company's app. And so I'll show you again how to do that later. But this is it in a nutshell, and also how to use. So I did bring in some usage guidelines here, which are really helpful to and kind of show you, you know, some of the things you should and shouldn't do while you're using this. So with that, let's jump in. So we got our tabs here. Each of these tabs represents a heuristic. So number one is visibility of system status. And I do have this populated just so that it doesn't error out the totals tab. I'll show you that in a second. But this is how this works. You just basically find an observation, and then you give it a result and a severity rating, and then any further details or notes. Always good to mention the page and the into a link a screenshot of your finding. And again, I'll go through this in the next video. This will show you whether UX research is required or not. And you can even link a Jira or whatever project management software you use issue into this as well for easy tracking. Next, we have match between system and real world. There are, I forgot to mention this, but inside of each of these heuristics, there are helpful videos and sometimes articles from NNG. And these are really well done. They're really succinct and explain these heuristics. And there's also a description as well to kind of reference quickly as needed. And number three, user control and freedom. Number four, consistency and standards. Number five, error prevention. Number six, recognition rather than recall. Number seven, flexibility and efficiency of use. Number eight, aesthetic and minimalist design. Number nine, help users recognize, diagnose, and recover from errors. And number 10, which is not used as much anymore since the 90s and 2000, early 2000s, there were a lot more needed help and documentation on websites because there weren't as many established user interface patterns. And so you saw this a lot more commonly on those websites. So again, I did hear Jakob mention this recently that, you know, if he could do it again, he probably wouldn't include this one. But, you know, you might find, you never know, you might find an example still that this applies to. Lastly, you have your totals tab. And this is what I was touching on before. The beauty of this template is that all of these areas here of your severity and your results and your UX research required, they're all have formulas attached to them. So this just makes it super easy at the end to aggregate all of this data and have this breakdown here that will again allow you to create something like this, just a simple graphic that you can share out and then, you know, have some more info on a Confluence page or whatnot. So anyway, that's it for this video. I hope it piqued your interest. I hope you're curious about it and you dive in and grab a copy. And again, stay tuned. Go right to the next video because I'm going to show you an actual live heuristic evaluation and how I use this template. Thanks.